Hello. We are going to use about 2 dozen balloons. Inflate all balloons leaving about 3-inch flat tail. As I mentioned in previously published instruction, arch 2, chain 2, head 7, we can use the same technique to work with sets of 2 and more balloons. So today we are going to work with sets of 3 balloons. I choose patriotic them, blue, white and red. Each set of 3 balloons has all 3 colors, white, blue and red. To begin with, we need 2 sets. Hold them crisscross in your hand. Place the same color balloons next to each other. Fold the first set of balloons and hold it in one hand at the point where you want to twist the first bubbles. We twist all bubbles of the same about 5-6 inch size. We are going to make straight lines color pattern. So each balloon stays next to the same color bubble. For example, after we twist the balloons, the blue balloon remains next to the blue bubble. And so on. Basically, at this point, you can see the color pattern that we are making right now. Keep twisting in the same color pattern to the end of the balloon. Obviously, the setup, the basic, the first position of all balloons, all colors, is very important for all color patterns. Especially, the key position of colors is crucial when we want to mix different color patterns in one sculpture. Alright, here we got to the end of the balloons. In this pattern, each balloon has 5 bubbles in straight line, and there is enough balloons left at the end to twist one more bubble. Let's put this sculpture aside for now. We are going to make spiral color pattern. Again, we start with 2 sets of 3 balloons each, patriotic colors. Again, we place the same color balloons next to each other. The second set of balloons goes in the direction we want the spiral to go. The way I put it here to my left, the spiral will go counterclockwise. We twist bubbles in any direction we are comfortable to. I twist bubbles to my right. However, we have to alternate the colors in the direction the spiral goes for this sculpture to the left. So in my sculpture, the blue balloon goes next to the red bubble. The white balloon goes next to the blue bubble, and the red balloon goes to the white bubble. I'm going to follow this color pattern to the end of these balloons. Working on big decorations or large size sculptures is always a time-consuming process. Working in a team is one sure way to make it faster. It is nice to have a professional to get even a little help. But, as I mentioned before in previous instructions, your assistant could be anyone. The most help you need is to hold the ends of large sculptures while you're working on the other end of the sculpture. Assistant can save you a lot of time just by inflating balloons, and so on and so forth. By now we can see clearly the spiral color pattern we are working on. I think it looks better when we use sets of 3 balloons and up for this pattern. You remember in previous instructions we used a set of 2 balloons to make spiral pattern. Keep it always in mind, the more balloons we use, the more time it takes to make it. Alright, let's take a look what we have done so far. In this sculpture we alternate colors to make the spiral color pattern. And here is the first stick we did today, using straight lines color pattern. Okay, let's put both sticks aside for now. This time I'm going to make the same spiral color pattern. The only difference is going to be the direction the spiral goes to. Let's move the second set balloons to the right or clockwise. Twist bubbles, every time alternate colors to the right or clockwise. At this point we can see clearly the direction spiral goes to. So let's see how different it is from previous sculpture. Our spirals go to opposite directions. Sure, you can find a lot of use for this optical trick in your decorations. For instance, you can make two poles twisted in opposite directions, then connect these poles in an arch. It looks really good. Or you can use the same two poles twisted in opposite directions to shape a heart. Oh man, I love this kind of decorations. There are so many colors, so many variations in color patterns. So much use for it. No way for me to show it in one video instruction. I think to add later some more pictures of color patterns, shapes and decorations to my blog post. You can find links to all posts at fewdoit.com. Alright, back to the sculpture. This way we can attach two poles to make an arch. Not a big deal. Just place the same colors next to each other at the point where you connect the balloons. We're going to make a pole. We will mix color patterns to make it. And then we will use it as an arch. So first I made a stick using straight lines color pattern. Cut off ends of the first set balloons, tie them in one knot, attach new set of three balloons, the same three colors. I want to have a mix of patterns in this order. Straight lines, then spiral, and then straight lines again. So now we place the balloons in order to make the spiral pattern. The blue balloon goes next to the red bubble, the red balloon goes next to the white bubble, and the white balloon goes next to the blue bubble. As you can see here, the direction the spiral goes, as well as position of colors, comes from previous straight lines pattern. Let's get rid of these short ends. Tie off the ends. Now we are going to attach the next set of three balloons. We do it in the same fashion, following the spiral pattern. I always ask myself one question before I start to make balloon sculpture. How many balloons would it take to make it? How many balloons of one particular color I need to have to make this sculpture? You have to make sure you have enough supplies before you start the work. For example, right now we are working to make an arch. How many balloons would it take to make the arch? It depends on the size. I'm going to use 10 balloons of each color to make a small size arch, which is quite suitable for little kids. Using the same pattern, just increasing the size to make it for adults, I will have to use, I would say, like at least 14 bubbles of each color. We also have to keep some spare balloons of each color for repairment work, which may be necessary occasionally it happened, balloons pop up. Yes, it is the nature of balloon twisting art. We cannot run away from it. Balloons do pop up. Yeah, it is a bad thing when balloons pop on one hand. On the other hand, people coming back to us right after the balloon pop, they want another sculpture. So, it's not so bad, right? It is the life story of every balloon we made. Alright, back to the sculpture. We come to the end of the balloons again. Just follow the same procedure as we did before. Cut off the ends, tie the ends in one knot. I cut ends of the balloons with my fingers. You can do it with scissors, whatever you're comfortable with. Tie off the ends nicely and then trim off the ends with scissors later if you want. Or you can just do as I do, hide the ends between bubbles. Attach new set of three balloons. Keep working in the same spiral pattern. Our spiral goes to the left, counterclockwise. I like this pattern a lot. I like the fact that the connection between bubbles, or between the balloons for the matter, is totally hiding from view. So you don't have to really worry about any extra decorations to hide the connections between balloons. Okay, let's make a long story shorter. We work in the same spiral color pattern to the end of the balloons. So far we made a pole. I think it's over 6 feet long. We can shape it in a circle, in a heart. Let's make an arch. I'm going to use two more sets of balloons to make the small size arch. I want to make both ends of the arch look exactly the same. So now I'm going to work in straight lines color pattern, the same color pattern we work with at the beginning. So we have to place the same color balloons next to the same color bubbles. If you want to make a larger size arch, just work with spiral color pattern as many sets as you want, and then finish with straight lines color pattern. If you don't use any special equipment, how are you going to attach your sculpture, the arch for example, to the floor? I would suggest to fill up number of balloons with water, rice, sand, whatever else available in your household. Then attach these heavy loaded balloons to the ends you want to put on the floor. You can use sewing thread, you can use sticky tape. Ask your assistants to handle it nicely. Let me repeat myself again. We can use the same technique, work in the same fashion with different number of balloons. In this example, we use sets of three balloons. We can work with sets of two and up, two and more balloons in one set. Your imagination is only limit of all those possibilities, all those designs we can make using this technique. Here I'm getting to the end of the balloons. Make sure to tie the ends nicely. Okay, congratulations! We have made the arch. If I made a bigger size, it won't fit on the screen. Wow! So I use 8 balloons of each color to make this arch. We work with 2 color patterns. Here's the straight lines. In middle of the sculpture we use spiral pattern. And on both ends of the sculpture we use straight lines pattern. We use 3 colors, white, blue, red, to make the patriotic zem arch. The same 3 colors work for 2 great nations, American and Russia. Art for peace, dedicated. Have fun and happy twisting.